Hello dear students, welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be understanding section 81 of Indian Penal Code. This is a very interesting section. As you can see on screen, the title of this section says it is about an act committed by someone, such an act which is likely to cause harm but done without criminal intent and to prevent other harm. So you can get an idea as to what this section is all about. It is about granting immunity to a man from criminal charge with respect to acts committed under compelling circumstances, forced by necessity. I have written that for you. Once again I repeat, it grants immunity to a man from criminal charge with respect to acts committed by that man under compelling circumstances, forced by necessity. Let's take a look at the text of this section and understand it properly. It says, nothing is an offense merely by reason of its being done with the knowledge that it is likely to cause harm. If it be done without any criminal intention to cause harm and in good faith for the purpose of preventing or avoiding other harm to person or property. Let me explain it to you in Hindi. केवल यह जानकारी होने के बावजूद की गई ऐसी कृति कि जिसके वजह से किसी को हानि हो सकती है, यह गुनाह नहीं होगी अगर वो किसी क्रिमिनल इंटेंशन के बिना की गई है, किसी को हार्म पहुंचाने के क्रिमिनल इंटेंशन के बिना की गई है और किसी दूसरे हार्म को, किसी व्यक्ति को होने वाले दूसरे हार्म को या किसी प्रॉपर्टी को होने वाले हानि को बचाने के लिए गुड फेथ में अगर की गई है तो इस प्रकार की कोई भी कृति गुनाह नहीं होगी. आई विल एक्सप्लेन दिस टू यू इन हिंदी टू मेक इट ईजी फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड. So friends, students, what this means is that aisi koi bhi kriti gunah nahi hogi keval is karan se ki wo kriti karte vakt kriti karne wale ko yah pata tha ki uski kriti ki wajah se koi hani ho sakti hai. Agar aisi kriti kisi bhi criminal intention के बिना की गई है और गुड फेथ में यानी अच्छे उद्देश्य से किसी और व्यक्ति को या किसी प्रॉपर्टी को होने वाली हानि बचाने के लिए अगर की गई है तो इस प्रकार की कृति गुनाह नहीं कहलाई जाएगी. सो दिस सेक्शन डील्स विद द डिफेंस ऑफ नेसेसिटी. It gives legal protection to the doctrine of salvage. That means self-preservation, means rescue of property and things from damage by wrecking, fire, etc. This section justifies the doing of a lesser evil in order to avoid a greater evil. Okay, this can be understood better by understanding the two illustrations given in this section itself. So let us take a look at the first illustration. Now imagine there is a steam vessel traveling, say, in a sea or maybe river, and there is a captain of that steam vessel, and at the same time there are two boats running nearby that steam vessel. Now for the purpose of our understanding, we will name the captain of the steam vessel as Mr. A एंड वी विल नेम वन बोट आउट ऑफ द टू द बोट विच इज कैरिंग 20 or 30 पैसेंजर्स एज बोट बी एंड अनदर बोट विच इज कैरिंग ओनली 2 पैसेंजर्स एज बोट सी. ओके, सो ए बी सी. नाउ इट सो हैपन्स दैट वेन द स्टीम वेसल इज ट्रैवलिंग ए द कैप्टन ऑफ द स्टीम वेसल सडनली and without any fault or negligence on his part, he finds himself in such a position that before he can stop his vessel, he will unavoidably hit boat B with 20 or 30 passengers on board. But he can avoid this by changing the course of the vessel. But the situation is such that if he changes the course of his vessel, he would hit boat C with only 2 passengers. And if he changes the course of the vessel, there is a possibility that he may even clearly go without hitting. Now, these are all possibilities. Now, finding himself in such a difficult situation, what A does is he takes a decision to change the course of his boat. Rather than hitting boat B, he takes the risk of hitting boat C. ठीक है? Now see, he has no intention to cause any harm to boat C. But under a compelling situation, he alters his course without any intention to run down or to hit boat B. And in good faith, for the purpose of avoiding the danger to the passengers in boat B. Now, if A does this, and if the vessel actually hits boat C, still A is not guilty of any offense. Even if A knew that by doing an act, he was likely to cause harm to boat C, and he would not be so guilty. Of course, if it is found as a matter of fact that the danger which he intended to avoid was such as to excuse him in incurring the risk of running down boat C. Now we will look at another illustration. Suppose there is a great fire and one man, namely A, he pulls down some houses to prevent the conflagration from spreading. That means to prevent the fire from spreading, he pulls down the houses. And he does this with the intention in good faith of saving human life or property. Now suppose if it is found that the harm to be prevented was of such a nature and so imminent as to excuse A's act, A is not guilty of the offense. ठीक है? So with these two illustrations, it is easy to understand this section. So to attract the provisions of this section, there are certain conditions which need to be satisfied, and please take those conditions into account, understand them well. The first is, there should be absence of criminal intention. The action must be done in good faith for the purpose of preventing or avoiding other harm to person or property. And mind well, this is an and. The lesser harm must have been done to avoid a greater harm. Now, what if someone raises a defense before the court by taking advantage of this section and claiming that he should be exempted from punishment with the aid of this section? Under such situations, an explanation is added to the said section, and it clarifies that it is a question of fact in such kinds of cases to find out whether the harm to be prevented or avoided was of such a nature and so imminent as to justify or excuse the risk of doing the act with the knowledge that it was likely to cause harm. So the court will embark upon a factual inquiry on the basis of evidence that will come before the court to assess whether the harm that was to be prevented or avoided was so imminent, was so urgent as to justify or excuse the risk of doing the act with the knowledge that it was likely to cause harm. So dear students, with this I have explained to you the basics of this section. For a deeper understanding of the section, I advise you all to actually read a good commentary of Indian Penal Code. So before I end this video, take a good look at the entire section in blue color by pausing this video for a few moments, and you will have a better understanding of this section. So dear students, thank you very much for watching this video. If you have liked this video, then definitely press the like button and share this video with your friends. You may also consider subscribing to my channel, because I will be coming up with many such video tutorials for my dear law students. Thank you for watching.